Hi there, welcome to Scrap and Coffee. In today's video, I have another project to share for you, the Vintage Traveler Mini Album. So I'm going to show you this mini album, but first I want to give a shout out to Frances from Your Book of Memories. She just came up with a new folio tutorial for it. She's calling it the Fun Folio. I will put a link down in this down in the description box for you. And in that she used some features that she was inspired by my Coffee and Friends folio. So if you haven't seen that one, I will put a link up on top. So thank you, Frances. Thank you so much. And it was great to see you use some of my features and that you were inspired by me, because obviously I am inspired by you as well. So thank you, thank you. So now for the album, I've made a mini album, and this is actually the album that got me starting with Scrap and Coffee. This was the first album that I have designed completely myself. For decoration, I've used the Simple Vintage Traveler collection by Simple Stories. It's an older collection. But Simple Stories always sells their collection digital, so you can still get it. Maybe in the bigger scrapbook stores you can find it as well, but it was from last year, so I don't know if it's still available. For this album, I've made 3 pages, but I've used 2 different page designs. So I've used 1 page design twice and 1 only once, but you can play around with it however you like. So for the measurements, because I don't remember, I'm going to check for you. It's 7.5 by 9 with a spine that measures 1 3/4. So it's a pretty simple album. The decoration is pretty plain. Like here, I've just used some patterned paper. I've wrapped the spine with a solid piece of the collection and just placed a strip to connect the papers and hide where they come together. And I've done the same thing on the back. And here I placed a little card bar that I've mounted onto this colored cardstock and then again on some craft cardstock. To make it look a little bit more vintage, I've inked the whole album with a vintage photo by Tim Holtz, Distress Ink. So all the edges, all the pages are inked to give it a little bit more of a vintage look. So when I'm opening it up, then this is what we have. Here on the front cover, I've made a little tuck-in space with one of the stickers out of the collection and placed a little 3x4 cut apart in there. You can journal on it or place a photo. Then we have a big flap. You can place a photo here, but I've used a 6x4 cut apart out of the collection. Here, some room for a photo. Again, a flap that you can place a 6x4 on, but I did a 4x4. And here a 6x4. Then we have a stack pocket. For some smaller photos in the front, you can place bigger photos in there, but I just like it if you place some smaller in the front and then some larger ones in the back. So, and the stack pocket I've made out of acetate. So you can still see the image, because this paper was one of my favorite papers. I really loved it and I want to be able to see the image. So I've made it out of acetate. And when you place your photos in there, you are also able to see what's in there. So I'm just going to place this here to keep everything in place. So on the first page, this design I've used twice. I've made an angled flap and an angled pocket. And on the top, I've placed one of the photo frames that I had in the kit with, I had some extra things out of the collection. And I left it open so you can place a 3x4 photo in there. Then when you flip this to the top, I've just placed some patterned paper here. And this is an angled pocket where you can place some larger photos in here. You can place 7x5 and smaller photos in here. So that closes again. I didn't use any magnets because the weight of the chipboard will keep it in place. On the back, I've made a large pocket with an acetate window. So you are able to place a large photo in here. Let me see, I think it accommodates for a 7x5. Yes, so a 7x5 photo will fit in there perfectly. But you can also place some patterned paper in there like I've done now. And just place some smaller photos in there. and just take them out when you want to look at them. My pattern paper at the moment isn't stuck down because I haven't decided yet on what I am going to do with it. Then we have here the page. I have two flaps and I've made a little swing tab to keep it all in place. And this is the only place where I have used a little magnet because the swing tab alone was not enough. It was still flapping around here in the bottom. So that's why I've used a little magnet there. This is a 4x4 cut apart out of the collection. Room for a photo here. And this one goes up. So that gives you this great area, large area for all different sizes of photos. You can play around with it. This is just an example of what you can do with it. Okay, so we can close that up again. And then a tuck space here with some stickers out of the collection. And then a large side pocket that opens up here for some larger photos again. Or smaller. A fun photo mat in here. There's more room for photos that you can place in there. And then I've made this protection sheet. That's something that I've learned from Caddy King from Paper Phenomena. Because I've placed another chipboard piece here. And it was catching on to my pocket here. So I've made this sheet out of acetate and some cardstock. Decorated it with some solid cardstock out of the collection. And just placed it on there. So your pocket is protected from that. So yeah, we have to watch what we're doing with decoration of pages, but yeah, sometimes it happens. And then this is a way to fix it. So this is the second page, the second design that I've only used once. A large pocket here, and on the pocket I've placed that frame, the chipboard frame. Again, I left it open so you can place your photo in there. More room for photos. 7x5 and smaller. Goes in there on the back. Again, I've made a sort of envelope style pocket. I used a swing tab, so it's a large pocket. Swing tab for closure, and again, room for larger photos in there. And for the swing tabs, I've just used some stickers out of the collection that I've mounted onto cardstock and some brads. And then we have a half page here. For room for photos, you can place 2 4x4s or 6x4 and then some pattern paper underneath there. So this was a 4x4. And then on the back of that I have two angled pockets that come together in the middle. You can place photos in there or cut apart. You have to crop down a 4x4 slightly to get it in here. And again a little tuck space. For some, yeah, here I've used some stickers out of the collection, but you can also place a small photo there if you want. And then we are back to page style number one again. Again, that angled pocket, and again, I've placed that chipboard frame on top of there that's open for a photo. So that flips up, and again, the weight will hold the flap down, so no magnets here. Decorated the top flap, and again, just room for larger photos in here. And then on the back, again, that big frame pocket. Again, I've just placed some patterned paper in there. But you can do with it whatever you like. A 7x5 picture or some smaller pictures in there. And then again, that page with the two flaps. Here I've used the swing tab on the bottom and no need for magnets. So that goes to the side and it opens up. So again, a lot of room for photos here. I've placed some larger photos so that less photo space because of the larger photos, but I could have placed another photo mat here or here. A lot of options. You can just play around with it and look at the photos that you have and see what is your need on photo sizes. And on the back again, that large side pocket. And I've placed some photo mats in there. And again, another fun, how do you call it? Photo mat. This is a design by Caddy King as well. I will put a link in the description box to the tutorial where I got this photo mats from. And also, you can find this one in that same tutorial. It's also from Caddy King. Caddy Order King. So this is really fun. You can open it up. It's a gatefold. And yeah, you can place a 2x3 and some pattern paper or two 2x2s. a 4x4 in the middle, close it, more room for small photos. I've placed some patterned paper on the back, but of course you can place a photo there, and then with a little belly band it will all keep it in place. So really fun feature. Again, I made a little tuck space here and placed some stickers out of the collection in there, just because it looks fun, a little bit more decorated. And on the back inside cover, I've made two pockets, and one was made with acetate. So you can take that out, and here again, room for 6x4. So in both pockets, you can place 6x4 photos or a photo mat. So that will go in there, and this will go in here. So it's really fun, but I'm not sure if I would do it again if I would make it out of acetate, because the matting of this, of the inside cover, is pretty, yeah, you make it pretty hard on yourself. So you have to think about it when you choose to use the acetate on there or not. So some fun features in here, but still I think it's pretty basic, pretty plain. It's all no big embellishments in here. So really fun album to make. And I will come up with a tutorial for both page styles. So keep an eye open for that if you want to know how I did it. And yeah, pretty fun album. I hope you liked it. So please give it a thumbs up if you did. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. And I hope to see you in the next video. Enjoy the rest of your day.